In this video, we are going to test if it's even possible to use a cheap CNC router, like the mostly printed CNC, to make lenses with good optical properties. So this part is all about trying to find the best way to make those lenses, and in the next part I'm going to show you how to design a lens and how accurate it will be. So let's get started. I am using 5 and 8 mm thick cast acrylic, which has great optical clarity and machines very nicely. But first, I am surfacing my wasteboard in order to get a flat surface on which I then use double-sided tape to stick down my acrylic sheets. As you can see, this right here is already my second try. On the first one, I had a problem doing the tool change and the lens got damaged. Right now, I am doing a 3D adaptive with a 3 mm single flute end mill, which is followed by parallel finishing passes with a 6 mm ball nose end mill. At least for my machine, this isn't the best way to cut the lens profile, and I'm going to show you my preferred way later on. Now I am wet sanding in order to get rid of the tool marks, starting with 400 grit sandpaper and going all the way to 2000 grit. After that, I am doing a quick polish and the first lens is finished. You can see that there are some tool marks left in the center and on the edges, but it still does a good job of focusing light. Of course, with a CNC router, you can make a lens in any shape you want, so let's try something different. Here you can see that even after polishing, there are still many scratches left on the surface. I'm using a polishing compound for high gloss car finishes, so maybe a special acrylic polishing compound would do a better job. Now I've got a cool trick for you. Look at that bright line back there. It is horizontal. Now take the lens we made before, combine the two lenses, and see what happens. The horizontal line has turned into a vertical line. Physics is truly fascinating. After cutting several more lenses, this right here came out to be my preferred way to make those. It is basically just a spiral toolpath with a very small step over of 0.05 mm and a 2D contour to cut out the lens from the stock material. The small ridges can be sanded easily and you don't have to do a tool change. So far I have only made so-called plano convex lenses. These are flat on one side and have a curvature on the other side. However, I also want to be able to make biconvex lenses, which have a curvature on both sides. So I'm using some special glue to combine two plano convex lenses. I think it came out beautifully, and it does not only perform fairly well as a magnifying glass, it can also turn my standard camera lens into a macro lens. Here I've added a flange with 4 holes to the lens. I'm using these holes to align the two parts while gluing them. I also recommend covering the outer surface of the lenses with something like plastic foil, like I did here, so you don't get any glue or additional scratches onto it. That's it for the first part. I'm fairly happy with the results, and I'm hoping to see you again in the next part, where I'm going to show you how to design a lens in Fusion 360, how to set its dimensions to get the focal lengths you want, and how accurate it will be. Thanks for watching, and have a great day!